Hey, what's up guys? Jeremy here. Linear rails come in a wide variety of shapes and sizes, and a good chunk of them are even custom made for specific projects. To make sure you can use your rail, RoboDK lets you create your own custom mechanism in just a few simple steps. Let's go through those together. The first step to create a linear rail is to import a 3D model. Here, I have a rail provided by Lucas Robotics. I will drag and drop the step file to load it in my station. I'm using a step file currently, but an IGES or STL would also work. Okay, now the 3D model is loaded. I can open the mechanism builder, so utilities and model mechanism or robot. The default option should be the one to create a linear rail. Here, you have all the indications and steps you need to follow. If you look at the image, it shows you how the rail and the carriage should be positioned and how it will move with respect to a base reference frame, FB for frame base. Frame base will be positioned at the zero position of the rail. We will be able to add a name to our mechanism here. Here, we will select our base frame. I will talk more on that in a few minutes. And finally, you can add the 3D model of the rail here and the motion direction and limits here. For the 3D model, there are two drop-down menus. This means we need two geometries or two objects here. Unfortunately, the 3D model we have is grouped in one piece. That's not really an issue as we can split it inside RoboDK. I will fast forward the part where I retrieve the 3D model colors and split it into two pieces, as I already did a tutorial on that subject. If you want to know how, you should really watch it. So let's do that. Now that we have an object called rail and one object called carriage, we are ready to go. So let's reopen the rail builder. So utilities and model mechanism or robot. Let's name the mechanism linear rail. Okay. Now we need to position our base frame. The exact position of your rail base will vary according to your setup. In this case, I will go for a normal or more generic approach. I will consider that my base frame should be at the zero position of the rail. So right here, I will go ahead and create a reference frame exactly there. So I'll create one and name it frame base. Now I need to modify the position of the frame. So let's open the frame panel. Okay. The origin of the station is right here. So if I use the measure tool, I can measure the position of this surface here. Just like that. Okay, now I have the distance between the origin and the center here. So I can press here and copy these values and paste them as the frame position. So just like that, the frame position now matches with the reference image we have in the rail builder. Now we just need to make sure the orientation are the same. So for that to happen, I need to rotate clockwise 90 degrees around X. So that means a rotation of minus 90 degrees. Right here. Perfect. Now everything should match properly. We can select our frame base here and the rail 3D models here with the drop-down menus. Now I can enter the length of the rail, or in fact the travel of the carriage. So here it's 5230 millimeters. So I will enter from 0 to 5230 for the minimum and maximum limits. I can press update to create the robot. RoboDK will automatically create a duplicate of the reference 3D model you imported. So this way you can reuse it in the future if you ever need to do so. But for now, I'll just hide them. I can move along the axis and everything seems great. so it can move in one direction, in the other direction. By default, the rail will always move along the x-axis. I will do a video on how to do otherwise in the future. When testing the rail, make sure it moves in the right direction and also make sure the limits are good. If I'm fine with the result, I can press OK on the model mechanism window. So just like that, in a few minutes, you are able to create any linear rail you want. That's pretty much everything for today's video. I hope you liked it. If you did, please subscribe to our channel. This way you won't miss any new tips or walkthroughs. If you have any technical questions, you should definitely visit our online forum. Our team will be happy to interact with you. In any case, have a great day, guys.